that are here at the Kraaft Shaak, and I am going to try and do a quick video for you here about using dilution sprays for backgrounds. Now, I'm not sure, but I just was told that these dilution sprays are not light fast, which means it will fade if not completely disappear in the sunlight, or even in daytime is how it was said to me. So if that's the case, then you probably don't want to use this particular technique for, say, a piece of art that you would hang on the wall, but works great for your art journals. Now, I did this just trying to create a background, and it was really quick and simple, and I wanted to share with you how I did that. And I won't be going into how I drew the face or anything. That's, I think, down the road, but just to show you some of the background of this particular piece. Hopefully you can see all the different layers that are in there. And I'll show you how I did that. So I started out with a couple of mixed media pieces of paper, and this Strathmore mixed media, this is a huge package, it's 11 by 14. I love this paper, it's very heavy, 140 pound, so it's very sturdy, will hold up to a lot of layers of media, and it has a smooth vellum surface, which means the finish, it doesn't have any roughness like you would get with watercolor paper. And I take a couple of those. I also have some tissue paper handy. This particular tissue paper, I just crumpled it up and used it to kind of blot some things, so you can see how that paper is going to turn out. And of course I'll use this tissue to wrap up the items as they get purchased in the store, but I use that to clean up my paper, but also to create some decorative tissue to share. So I have some tissue. I have remnants of a kitchen roll. I'm probably going to run out in the middle of this, but kitchen roll, listen to me, I sound like Dyan now. This is a paper towel roll. And I'll show you what we do with one. Oh, I also have a stencil, and this, I don't know if you're familiar with these. Let me move this out of the way so you can see it better. This is one of those plastic canvas. I bought a whole package of these, saved a few for myself, and gave a few in packages as I mail out things. So if you found this in your package, you're probably wondering why. That's why, so that you could use this the way I'm going to show you how I use it. Okay, for the color, so I have a stencil. This one is bubbles, but any stencil will work. And the dilution spray. So I have pretty much a rainbow mixture here. I have squeezed orange, post box red, lemon zest, funky fuchsia, after midnight, and cut grass. And then I also have some neutrals. This one is melted chocolate, and this one is a pigment white linen spray. This one has a clacker in there to keep it mixed up. The rest of these are all flat. They don't have anything to mix up, so you don't have that clacker thing. I'm also going to use some Stazon jet black ink. And I did draw with my artist pens and my skinny ones, the big brush, the skinny ones, and of course my white gel pen to do all that, but that part we're not going to show here on screen today, just the background. Okay, so go ahead, we'll get started now. So I take my one piece, and I did start with the lightest color first, and the reason why I did that is because I figured I could put a bunch of this down and the rest will kind of mingle together. And I held mine sideways, even though I ended up using it this way, because I let the piece speak to me after I finished it. So anyway, these colors are just so vibrant. It's amazing. They're lots of fun to play with. And this is basically exactly what I did with that other piece. So as I pull out the yellow and sprayed the yellow, and you'll see there's quite a bit on there. And while it's still wet, I went in with some orange. And although there's some of it is overlapping, I'm not really covering up the yellow, per se, not yet. And I'm getting darker and darker, so I'm using a little bit less and less. And see how some of those colors blend together, and now you're starting to see less of the yellow as it does that. Now, before we get to mud, this is where the kitchen roll comes in for me. And actually, even before I do that part, I take another piece. This is why we had two pieces of the mixed media paper. I'm gonna put one right on top of the other, squish it around, this will just use up some of that excess ink that's on that first paper. And it'll kind of blend it together too. So now we're basically doing two for one here. Set that aside. And there's still some pretty good puddles here. I'm just gonna use my kitchen roll, or gosh, why do I keep saying that? Because she taught me, that's why. And I'm just gonna roll this over the top here, the paper towel right over the top. Those of you in the UK, I'm pretty sure that's what you call that, is kitchen roll, but I'm not gonna pretend I'm in the UK. Okay, so now I'm gonna use the funky fuchsia. Moving into now the cooler colors. These are all the warm colors. Now we're gonna move into the cooler colors. And because this fuchsia is similar to pink, it still works with the warm color palette. And this one is After Midnight. Now this one I'm gonna use very sparingly because it's very dark. And you'll notice where it is kind of going over some of that, it's gonna mix in a little bit. All right, now that green, bring in that green, and you'll notice that the yellow has kind of disappeared some. Now, where I put the green and the blue together, along with the red, it's gonna kind of turn dark. So I don't use this green as much. All right, so that's all of our colors. Now I'm gonna go back in with the yellow, that first color I started with, and I'm gonna fill in all these spots. And notice how it starts to run together. That's where I would normally pick up my, right there we go. I would pick up, I'm a little bit off camera, I didn't mean to do that. Pick up my paper again, and we're gonna just go right on in and soak up some of that we just made a mess with. And it's oozing out the sides and stuff, and that's okay, we don't mind. If you had tags and things just ready to sop that up, that's a good idea too. And there you can see the colors really mix together and make a whole fun mess. So you can see what's going on there. All right, again with the paper towel, and I'm just gonna sop up some of this brown that has kind of become a part of it. All right. Now I do notice as I'm looking at this that there are quite a bit of white spots still. And I decide at this point if I wanna keep it like it is, or if I wanna blend some more. If I wanna keep it like it is, then I need to get out the heat tool. So for that, I will pause. And just make sure it's all nice and dry before I go any further. All right, now when I said that I wanted it nice and dry, what I really meant was that I didn't want any puddles left on the page. This is still fairly wet, but I don't have any glaring puddles like you see here. It's clearly wet up in here. So this is ready to move on. This one could use a little bit more heat, but rather than wasting my time with that, I'm just gonna take the paper towel and dab those parts off. Now you notice that when you use your paper towel, you're removing the ink, so you actually end up with a lighter, with it looking lighter there. If you let it dry, it's much darker. So depending on what you want your end result to be, that's what you're gonna do. Either have some patience and let it dry for the dark result, or go ahead and remove the ink and just leave a lighter color. Now I've got my two pieces that I can work with, and again, I'm noticing here that there's quite a bit of white still left in some of these areas, and make sure you can see that. And I want to make sure that this is really a very saturated with color piece, and there's a lot of white left on here. So We are going to take our, I think for this one, I'm going to go ahead and finish off with the yellow. Like I started to tell you, I go right back to that very first color I started with, and I'm going to go back into those areas where the white is still showing and where there might have been some too much overspray. And I love how it just mixes with those colors to give it even more. Now, because we did dry most of it, it's not mixing as much as it would have if we'd have left it turn into a brown puddle. Now, of course, you could just leave it like this, but we're going to take, told you I'd run out. I'm going to take my paper towel and I'm going to soak this up a little bit. And that's going to create even more texture in that background, which is part of what I did, that why I needed to show you in a video what I did, because I don't really know how to explain this so that it makes sense. But wadding up the paper towel and just pressing it down in certain areas takes some of that off and makes it just a lighter background in some areas. Very cool effect. And I'm not sure if you can see that there's texture from the paper towel left in the paint as well, or in the ink, I mean. Quite fun, very expressive. All right, so we're gonna set this aside for a minute and we're gonna work on the other one that's not finished. And I'm gonna grab some more paper towel. At least I thought I was. I'm completely out of paper towel. I thought I had more down here. Okay, well, we'll do the rest of this without paper towel then. All right, so I like that fuchsia color, but it didn't really translate onto this page very much. So we're going to kind of go a different direction with this one. And I also like that green that doesn't seem to have played well with others on this paper. So we're going to add that bright green right back over here. And of course, some more yellow, because I just don't think we can get enough yellow. Now, as I'm looking at this one, I'm seeing that it's really starting to mix. So I'm just going to dab that really quick before it becomes too much. Spray a little bit more. See how brighter that is already? Just a little bit there. Oh, I like how that's moving. I do like that. Now you can have some fun with this. You can actually pick it up and let it drip if you like that sort of thing. Notice how it starts to pull away. I like that. That's got some grooviness to it. Let's see. Some orange in there. Let's just throw a little bit of orange up here. And where it's liquid already, and then the spray comes into effect, it's really going to make some movement for you. Before I dab that, let's give it some more drips. Very cool. I am liking that. And let's see. Just making a little bit more texture with that paper towel in certain areas. All right, I think I like that. I think we're gonna call that one good. Now, before this dries, I'm gonna take the bubbles stencil and I'm gonna spray it with some water. And you know what, before I do that, I need some paper towel. All right, so I've got a new roll of paper towel, and what I'm gonna do is take my bottle of spray, this is just a spray bottle filled with water, and I'm just gonna hold this down in the center here because my paper is somewhat warping from the wetness already, but just gonna mist this pretty good. And using the paper towel, I'm just gonna roll over and basically sop up. I love that, isn't that so cool? Basically, I'm sopping up that water, but I'm also taking some of that ink off as I do that. And I believe Dyan calls this a ghosting. Could be wrong. All right, and then I'm going to just roll back right over it again and sop up any of that excess. Now hopefully you can see this on camera, but it's created sort of a bubbled effect there. Very fun. And I'm gonna do it over here on the other side as well. Now I do need to take, what I have done is taken that and just put it onto another piece of paper, but I don't have another piece of paper ready. So I'm not gonna do that. Look at what it's doing to that paper towel. That is so cool. I think I'm gonna take that off and use that in my wrappings. All right, so we'll go over here to the other side, and I don't really care so much about overlap because you really can't see it. It just adds to the texture. So again, spray, spray, spray. And this one we'll let sit for a little bit while I take this paper towel off. And as you let it sit, it kind of reacts with the ink and the paper a little bit more. Now you don't have to clean off your paper towel like I just did. I just want to save that because I like those bubbles on there. So, all right. And we're going to get a lot more effect on this one because we let it sit a little bit longer. So these are some of the things you want to play with. Now, if you're not used to using sprays, this is a messy thing. So I don't know if you can see. No, you can't. Off camera, it's a mess up here. See, making a mess. But that's fine. This is part of the fun here. Now, as I take this off, I'm going to put it over here. And I'm going to roll that again. And you're going to see that effect is just really bright. Really shiny right there. So here it was where, I'm not sure if you can see, but it didn't last very long right there. We didn't leave it on the paper very long, so this is kind of how it looks over here, and here's what it looks like when you leave it on the paper much longer. It's fun. All right, I'm gonna hit this with the heat tool again. Okay, so here I'm bringing in the first page that we did. This was actually our main focal page, and this was the mop-up page, basically. So now, with that main, we're gonna do the same thing with this, only this time I'm going to use white instead of, so this is the white linen, and instead of using the water, I'm gonna actually spray with white. And I'm not spraying the entire thing, and there's a reason for that. Just because I really like how that looks. Very spacey. All right, and I'm just gonna flip it over. Now the ink is on this side, and I'm just gonna lay it down over here. And again, with my paper towel, we're just gonna push it down onto there so that all that yummy white gets put down. So there we go. Gives it a very cool effect. And we're gonna hit that with the heat tool so it will dry with those swirls. Okay, so one of the things I really like about doing this part here is that it really takes shape without thinking. So, you know, you saw how, let's see, I did it this direction, didn't I? But as I'm moving it around and drawing it, I see kind of mountains or something like that. So whatever, as it becomes something, it might determine where you place things or not. I mean, just let it go. Don't try to overthink it too much. All right, so down here, what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to use some black stays on, and I'm just going to press down, and I'm doing it right here on the mat because I don't mind right here on the art, because I think that those, it will just add to things here. You can see what I'm talking about as I go in, and I push down really hard, and it leaves these really cool marks. Can you see that? My window wasn't in the way. There we go. So this just leaves a very different look to it than what you might originally expect. So I'm just going to do that randomly all over the place. All right, now the same exact thing. This is just the stamp side here. I'm just going to flip it over, stamp side down. It doesn't really matter, but I like it. Kind of has a curve to it, so I like the curve to. I don't want it to get in the way of the ink, so I'm going to use this melted chocolate, which is a brown color, and I'm just going to give it a really good spray. And I don't care about overspray, and then I lift it straight up, and you'll notice it's got some puddles. I might leave those. Yeah, I think I'll leave those. And we're going to do the same thing over here. I'm just going to do this randomly. All right, and then let's get out the white and do the same thing with the white. So I just wiped off my... And it gives a whole different look. I mean, here is the stamp. Let's see if I can zoom in so you can really see what we're talking about here. But here is the stamp, and here's what it looks like when it's sprayed through as a stencil. And you'll see it sprayed through as a stencil with white. And the heavier the spray, the more opaque the white will be. So in these areas, it's very ghost-like. That's the white spray we did. We're gonna do the same thing, but it's going to be much heavier this time, so we can get a little bit more. Now this time without, I moved it anyway. I was gonna say without moving it, I'm just gonna pick up some of that, and I wasn't able to do it. So we'll just leave it like that. Try it again over here. And it might be better to do in layers. Now that I'm thinking about it, I think I did it in layers. All right, and there you see the effect of that white, the opaque white, and how it picks up some of those colors from below. So I'm gonna just out so you can get a better idea of the entire piece. It's not totally dry, but at least you'll understand how I got all those layers pretty quickly. And depending on which way you turn it as to what it really says to you and what you're going to do with it. A couple more. Here's a view of that. This is actually the mop-up piece to this one. So you notice that the colors are a little bit lighter. I did use the water on this one as opposed to the white, so maybe in some of these dark areas I will go ahead and use the white. And I really like that overspray. I think the overspray is a good idea. And this time I'm going to take it and flip it over without wiping it off and just lay it down over there, and using a paper towel, push it down into the paper. There we go. Pretty neat. I like that. So I'll just... that's how I create my backgrounds, using my new Dylusions sprays, and of course they're available at the Kraaft Shaak store. There you have it. Some backgrounds, a couple of different ways you can use stencils and such, and of course how you can finish it off and use those backgrounds for a beautiful piece of art in your journal. There you go. Have a super crafty day. Bye-bye.